This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. AEF 1st Army 2nd Army 4th Army 5th Army Siamese Expeditionary Force 5th Army Strength AEF, 12 million personnel 380 tanks 840 planes 2,780 artillery pieces 450,000 personnel casualties and losses total, 192,000 to 122,063 26,277 killed. 95,786 wounded, 70,000 total, see 126,000 28,000 dead, 26,000 POW 874 artillery pieces VE 100 days offensive Amiens 2nd Somme Scarpe 1918 Mont Saint Quentin Havrincourt Street Mihail Epehi Canal du Nord Street Quentin Canal Meuse Argonne 5th Ypres 2nd Cambrai Courtrai Celle Valenciennes Sambre The Meuse Argonne Offensive, also known as the Meuse Argonne Offensive and the Battle of the Argonne Forest, was a major part of the final Allied offensive of World War I that stretched along the entire Western Front. It was fought from September 26, 1918, until the armistice of 11 November 1918, a total of 47 days. The Meuse Argonne Offensive was the largest in United States military history, involving 12 million American soldiers, and was one of a series of Allied attacks known as the Hundred Days Offensive, which brought the war to an end. The battle cost 28,000 German lives and 26,277 American lives, making it the largest and bloodiest operation of World War I for the American Expeditionary Force AEF, which was commanded by General John J. Pershing. American losses were exacerbated by the inexperience of many of the troops and tactics used during the early phases of the operation. The Meuse Argonne was the principal engagement of the AEF during World War I. Contents. 1 Overview 2 Prelude 21 Opposing Forces Reims to Argonne 22 Objective 3 Battle 31 First Phase, September 26 to October 3 32 Second Phase, October 4 to October 28 33 Third Phase, October 28 to November 11 4 Legacy 5 See also 6 References 7 Further Reading Overview This section needs additional citations for verification. Please help improve this article by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. September 2016 Learn how and when to remove this template message. The logistical prelude to the Meuse attack was planned by then Colonel George Marshall, who managed to move American units to the front after the Battle of St. Mihail. The big September-October Allied breakthroughs north, center and south across the length of the Hindenburg Line, including the Battle of the Argonne Forest, are now lumped together as part of what is generally remembered as the Grand Offensive, also known as the Hundred Days Offensive by the Allies on the Western Front. The Meuse Argonne Offensive also involved troops from France, while the rest of the Allies, including France, Britain and its Dominion and Imperial Armies, mainly Canada, Australia and New Zealand, and Belgium contributed to major battles in other sectors across the whole front. The French and British armies' ability to fight unbroken over the whole 4 years of the war in what amounted to a bloody stalemate is credited by some historians with breaking the spirit of the German army on the Western Front. The Grand Offensive, including British, French and Belgian advances in the north along with the French-American advances around the Argonne Forest, is in turn credited for leading directly to the armistice of 11 November 1918 on September 26, the Americans began their strike towards Sedan in the south, British and Belgian divisions drove towards Ghent, Belgium on the 27th, and then British and French armies attacked across northern France on the 28th. The scale of the overall offensive, bolstered by the fresh and eager but largely untried and inexperienced U.S. troops, signaled renewed vigor among the Allies and sharply dimmed German hopes for victory. The Meuse Argonne Offensive, shared by the U.S. forces with the French 4th Army on the left as shown on the accompanying map and armistice, was the biggest operation and victory of the American Expeditionary Forces AEF in World War I. The bulk of the AEF had not gone into action until 1918. The Meuse Argonne Battle was the largest frontline commitment of troops by the U.S. Army in World War I, and also its deadliest. Command was coordinated, with some U.S. troops, e.g., the Buffalo Soldiers of the 92nd Division and the 93rd 23rd Division attached and serving under French command e.g. 17th Corps during the second phase 157th Eidrit hand flag drawn by General Mariano Guibert. The main U.S. effort of the Meuse-Argonne offensive took place in the Verdun sector, immediately north and northwest of the town of Verdun, between 26 September and 11 November 1918. However, far to the north, U.S. troops of the 27th and 30th Divisions of the 2nd Corps AEF fought under British command in a spearhead attack on the Hindenburg Line with 12 British and Australian divisions, and directly alongside the exhausted veteran divisions of the Australian Corps of the 1st Australian Imperial Force 1st AIF with artillery and British tanks. The combined three-nation force, despite some early setbacks, attacked and captured their objectives, including Montbrihane village along a 6-kilometer section of the line between Bellecourt and Vendhui, which was centered around an underground section of the St. Quentin Canal and came to be known as the Battle of St. Quentin Canal, although the capture of the heights above the Borevoir line by October 10, marking a complete breach in the Hindenburg line, was arguably of greater immediate significance. The important U.S. contribution to the victory at the St. Quentin Canal is less well remembered in the United States than Meuse-Argonne prelude. Opposing forces Reince to Argonne. The American forces initially consisted of 15 divisions of the U.S. 1st Army commanded by then General John J. Pershing until October 16, and then by Lieutenant General Hunter Liggett. The logistics were planned and directed by then Colonel George C. Marshall. The French forces next to them consisted of 31 divisions, including the 4th Army under Henri Gouraud and the 5th Army under Henri Matthias Berthelot. The U.S. divisions of the AEF were oversized 12 battalions per division versus the French, British, German 9 battalions per division, being up to twice the size of other Allies' battle-depleted divisions upon arrival, but the French and other Allied divisions had been partly replenished prior to the Grand Offensive, so both the U.S. and French contributions in troops were considerable. Most of the heavy equipment, tanks, artillery, aircraft was provided by the European Allies for the Meuse-Argonne front alone. This represented 2,780 artillery pieces, 380 tanks and 840 planes. As the battle progressed, both the Americans and the French brought in reinforcements. Eventually, 22 American divisions would participate in the battle at one time or another, representing two full field armies. Other French forces involved included the 2nd Colonial Corps, under Henri Claudel, which had also fought alongside the AEF at the Battle of Saint-Mihiel earlier in September 1918. German soldiers at a water hole, May 1915. The opposing forces were wholly German during this period of the war. German divisions procured only 50% or less of their initial strength. The 117th Division, which opposed the U.S. 79th Division during the offensive's first phase, had only 3,300 men in its ranks. Morale varied among German units. For example, divisions that served on the Eastern Front would have high morale, while conversely divisions that had been on the Western Front had poor morale. Resistance grew to approximately 200,000 to 450,000 German troops from the 5th Army of Group Gallwitz commanded by General Georg von der Marwitz. The Americans estimated that they opposed parts of 44 German divisions overall, though many fewer at any one time objective. The objective was the capture of the railway hub at Sedan, which would break the railway network supporting the German army in France and Flanders. Battle first phase, September 26 to October 3. Ruined church at Montfaucon d'Argonne. The blocky structure on the left is a German World War I observation post. During the 3 hours preceding H hour, the Allies expended more ammunition than both sides managed to fire throughout the 4 years of the Civil War. The cost was later calculated to have been $180 million, or $1 million per minute. The American attack began at 5:30. Frontal attack against strong, hostile positions fully manned by a determined enemy. The German counterattack had shattered so much of the 35th Division, a poorly led division. Most of its key leaders were replaced shortly before the attack, made up of National Guard units from Missouri and Kansas, that it had to be relieved early, though remnants of the division subsequently re-entered the battle. Part of the adjacent French attack met temporary confusion when one of its generals died. However, it was able to advance 9 miles, penetrating deeply into the German lines, especially around Somme-Py. The Battle of Somme-Py French, but Bataille de Sampy and northwest of Reims the Battle of Saint-Thierry. French, Bataille de Saint-Thierry. The initial progress of the French forces was thus faster than the 2 to 5 miles gained by the adjacent American units. However, the French units were fighting in a more open terrain, which is easier to attack. Second phase, October 4 to October 28. A German Hanover CL-3 shot down on October 4 between Montfaucon and Sierges 328th Infantry Regiment of 82nd Infantry Division line of advance in capture of Hill 223 on October 7, 1918. Stereoscope of the ruins of the Battle of Montfaucon. The second phase of the battle began on 4 October, during which time all of the original Phase 1 assault divisions, the 91st, 79th, 37th and 35th of the U.S. 5th Corps, were replaced by the 32nd, 3rd and 1st Divisions. The 1st Division created a gap in the lines when it advanced 1.5 miles against the 37th, 52nd, and 5th Guards Divisions. It was during this phase that the Lost Battalion affair occurred. The battalion was rescued due to an attack by the 28th and 82nd Divisions. The 82nd attacking soon after taking up its positions in the gap between the 28th and 1st Divisions on October 7. The Americans launched a series of costly frontal assaults that finally broke through the main German defenses. The Kriemhold Stelling of the Hindenburg Line between 14 to 17 October. The Battle of Montfaucon. French, Bataille de Montfaucon. By the end of October, U.S. troops had advanced 10 miles and had finally cleared the Argonne Forest on their left. The French had advanced 20 miles, reaching the Aisne River. It was during the opening of this operation, on October 8, that Corporal later Sergeant Alvin York made his famous capture of 132 German prisoners near Cornay. Third phase, October 28 to November 11. By October 31, the Americans had advanced 15 kilometers and had finally cleared the Argonne Forest on their left. The French had advanced 30 kilometers, reaching the River Aisne. The American forces reorganized into two armies. The first, led by General Liggett, would continue to move to the Carignan-Sedan-Mézières Railroad. The second army, led by Lieutenant General Robert L. Bullard, was directed to move eastward towards Metz. The two U.S. armies faced portions of 31 German divisions. During this phase, the American troops captured German defenses at Buzency, allowing French troops to cross the River Aisne, whence they rushed forward, capturing Le Chesnay. The Battle of Chesnay. French, Bataille du Chesnay. In the final days, the French forces conquered the immediate objective, Sedan and its critical railroad hub. The advance to the Meuse. French, Posse vers la Meuse. On November 6, and American forces captured surrounding hills on November 11. News of the German armistice put a sudden end to the fighting legacy. This article contains weasel words, vague phrasing that often accompanies biased or unverifiable information. Such statements should be clarified or removed. January 2013. American cemetery at Romans-sous-Montfaucon. Destruction seen in 1920. Although the Meuse-Argonne was the deadliest battle in U.S. history, in that it left a large number of U.S. dead, over 26,000, the battle is largely forgotten in the United States, citation needed, and the Argonne War Cemetery is often ignored by tourists. The battle also hailed the debut of the Browning automatic rifle in combat, with both the U.S. and France using them significantly for the first time in battle. According to the American view, the bottle's pressure on the Germans was an important factor in their agreeing to the armistice. Until the last, this battle had worried German commanders most. Unlike other sectors of the front, here they had little space short of a vital objective that they could afford to trade for time. Historians have since begun to debate the legitimacy of this claim, with many believing that the Meuse-Argonne offensive was simply a diversion from greater Allied offensives and successes elsewhere. In an interview, Paul von Hindenburg stated, "So I must really say that the British food blockade and the American blow in the Argonne decided the war for the Allies, and that, without the American troops and despite a food blockade, the war could have ended in a sort of stalemate." See also American Order of Battle. Meuse-Argonne Offensive. Code Talker references. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Battle of the Argonne Forest. Carrot ABC. Keith Hart, 1982, A Note on the Military Participation of Siam in World War I, PDF. Journal of the Siam Society, retrieved 19 July 2015. America's Deadliest Battle, Meuse-Argonne, 1918. Lawrence, University Press of Kansas. Carrot ABC. Meuse River Argonne Forest Offensive, the 26th of September to the 11th of November 1918. History of War.org, retrieved the 26th of September 2013. And forced the Imperial German Command to sue for armistice. Further reading. Baker, Horace L. 2007. Argonne Days in World War I. Columbia, University of Missouri Press. ISBN. Mead. Mesopotamia, South Arabia, African Southwest East Cameroon, Togoland, North Asian and Pacific, Tsingtao, German New Guinea and Samoa at Sea, North Atlantic U-boat campaign, Mediterranean, North Sea, Baltic, Indian, Pacific. Madras, Penang, Cocos, Coronel, Falkland Islands, Massa, Tierra, Principal Participants, People, Entente Powers, China, French Empire, Belgium, British Empire, Greece, Italy, Japan, Montenegro, Portugal, Romania, Russia, Russian Empire, Russian Republic, Serbia, United States, Central Powers, Germany, Austria, Hungary, Ottoman Empire, Bulgaria. Timeline, pre-war conflicts, scramble for Africa 1880-1914, Russo-Japanese War 1905, First Moroccan Tangier Crisis 1905-06, Agadir Crisis 1911. Italo-Turkish War 1911-12, French conquest of Morocco 1911-12, First Balkan War 1912-13, Second Balkan War 1913, Prelude, Origins, Sarajevo assassination, anti-Serb riots in Sarajevo, July Crisis, Autumn 1914, Battle of the Frontiers, Battle of Cer, First Battle of the Marne, Siege of Tsingtao, Battle of Tannenberg, Battle of Galicia, Battle of the Masurian Lakes, Battle of Kolubara, Battle of Sarakamish, Race to the Sea, First Battle of Ypres 1915, Second Battle of the Masurian Lakes, Second Battle of Ypres, Battle of Gallipoli, Second Battle of Artois, Battles of the Isonzo, Great Retreat, Second Battle of Champagne, Kosovo Offensive, Siege of Kut, Battle of Luz 1916, Erzurum Offensive, Battle of Verdun Lake, Narok Offensive, Battle of Asiago, Battle of Jutland, Battle of the Somme, Brusilov Offensive, Baranovici Offensive, Battle of Romani Monastir Offensive, Battle of Transylvania 1917, Capture of Baghdad, First Battle of Gaza, Zimmerman Telegram, Second Battle of Aris, Kerensky Offensive, Third Battle of Ypres, Paschendaele, Battle of Maricesti, Battle of Caporetto, Southern Palestine Offensive, Battle of Cambrai, Armistice of Erzincan 1918, Operation Faustschlag, Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, Spring Offensive, Second Battle of the Marne, Battle of Baku, 100 Days Offensive, Vardar Offensive, Battle of Megiddo, Third Transjordan Attack, Meuse Argonne Offensive, Battle of Vittorio Veneto, Battle of Aleppo, Armistice of Salonika, Armistice of Mudros, Armistice of Villa Giusti, Armistice with Germany, other conflicts, Mexican Revolution 1910-20, Somaliland Campaign 1910-20, Libyan Resistance Movement 1911-43, Meretz Rebellion 1914-15, Zayan War 1914-21, Indo-German Conspiracy 1914-19, Senussi Campaign 1915-16, Volta Boni War 1915-17, Easter Rising 1916, Anglo-Egyptian Darfur Expedition 1916, Khaosan Revolt 1916-17, Russian Revolution 1917, Finnish Civil War 1918, Post-war conflicts, Russian Civil War 1917-21, Ukrainian Soviet War 1917-21, Armenian-Azerbaijani War 1918-20, Georgian-Armenian War 1918, German Revolution 1918-19, Revolutions and Interventions in Hungary 1918-20, Hungarian-Romanian War 1918-19, Greater Poland Uprising 1918-19, Estonian War of Independence 1918-20, Latvian War of Independence 1918-20, Lithuanian Wars of Independence 1918-20, Third Anglo-Afghan War 1919, Egyptian Revolution 1919, Polish-Ukrainian War 1918-19, Polish-Soviet War 1919-21, Irish War of Independence 1919-21, Turkish War of Independence, Greco-Turkish War 1919-23, Turkish-Armenian War 1920, Iraqi Revolt 1920, Polish-Lithuanian War 1920, Vlora War 1920, Franco-Syrian War 1920, Soviet-Georgian War 1921, Irish Civil War 1922-23, Aspects, Opposition, Pacifism, Anti-War Movement, Deployment, Schlieffen Plan, German Plan 17, French Warfare, Military Engagements, Naval Warfare, Convoy System, Air Warfare, Cryptography, Horse Use, Poison Gas, Railways, Strategic Bombing Technology, Trench Warfare, Total War, Christmas Truce, Last Surviving Veterans, Civilian Impact, Atrocities, Prisoners, Casualties, Economic History, 1918, Flu Pandemic, Destruction of Kalish, Rape of Belgium, German Occupation of Belgium, German Occupation of Luxembourg, German Occupation of Northeastern France, Ober Ost Ottoman People, Armenian Genocide, Assyrian Genocide, Pontic Greek Genocide, Blockade of Germany, Women, Australia, Popular Culture, German Prisoners of War in the United States, Agreements, Partitioning of the Ottoman Empire, Sykes-Picot Agreement, Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne, French-Armenian Agreement, Damascus Protocol, Paris Peace Conference, Venizelos-Titoni Agreement, Treaties, Treaty of Brest-Litovsk, Treaty of Lausanne, Treaty of London, Treaty of Neuilly, Treaty of Saint-Germain, Treaty of Sèvres, Treaty of Trianon, Treaty of Versailles. Consequences, aftermath, 14 points. League of Nations, World War I memorials, centenary commemorations, category, portal, World War I at Wiktionary. World War I textbooks at Wikibooks, World War I quotations at Wikiquote, World War I source texts at Wikisource, World War I images.